I was in Nova Scotia and I was driving to Cape Breton, and I was on my way to visit my brother in his trailer. I passed a sign that said something like New Magic Mountain something. And it was kind of a tattered old sign, and it looked like it was just so sad for this happy sign. And then I was thinking, and all of a sudden I just had this idea about my brother and his life in this sort of isolated in this trailer, and the idea of Cape Breton and its sort of its beauty and its horror. And so the idea of this play came to me rather formed. I think what I've inherited, what I as part of my makeup, is this idea of indirectness, or the idea of understanding indirectness. I think all my plays have a kind of indirectness. So it's never what anyone's saying that's the point. It's what they're not saying, and that's what life in Cape Breton is like. It's a little bit like you're always skirting it and you're never really saying it. Certainly in the working class part of Cape Breton that I come from. Well, I mean, I think certainly in a lot of places where people are faced with struggle, you have two choices, you laugh or you cry. So you laugh, you know? And I mean, I think Cape Breton is a place of a great deal of struggle, and it always has. So we understand how to use humor. When you grow up on an island, you understand endings in a different way. You understand that things end in a way that when you grow up sort of on the prairie or something, there's this sort of endlessness to things. But when I think those of us who grow up on islands understand, or have a darker sense of humor perhaps, just because we understand that, yep, it ends. You go this far and it ends, and 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 it's done.